of losing control. Is that a first generation challenge or is that also a second generation challenge?
See, I'm a fifth generation businessman. My family has been in the gold business for five generations. See, for me, it's changed. I'm open.
Okay.
I don't fear losing control. But yes, somewhere down the line, yes. That fear is there. Still there.
That minor,
small feel is still there. Because it is now my baby. Maybe I have taken it from the initial stages and got it here. So, of course, that fear of losing control is still there.
So, Narayana Murthy managing Infosys with less than 10% doesn't inspire confidence for...
You know, but what I'm trying... But that fear will never allow me to expand or grow. So, I've reached a stage where my next step definitely... I have to let it go. So that's the state where I am. If I don't let go, I'll be still here. The curve has been, as in economics, they say, the curve goes up like this, and we are here. So now it's like that. Now, so I want to take this step, I need to let it go.
Yeah. I'll just touch on what Akshay talked about, this fear of losing control, which is a very normal kind of fear that any entrepreneur and especially a fifth generation guy will also have, because it's a family business. And one of the things which entrepreneurs should be looking at is that, as he correctly says, if I need to grow, I will probably need not just finance, but also other inputs, technical inputs, management inputs, which I don't all have it on with me. And with my present set of team. So it's important to understand that it's not just the money which is coming in, but there are lots of other things which are coming in. When you look at a set of people like investors, you're also looking at these additional things which are coming in. And the other thing which entrepreneurs should look at is that if someone is really interested in putting their money with you, it means that they have belief in you. So there is no need for them to put the money in and then throw you out. Yeah. Because then they can actually start their own business themselves. They don't really need to do this. So they have, bought into you, into how you are, into your beliefs, into your strengths, etc. So this fear should not be there. But what is very, very important is from the entrepreneur side, is that you need to move from a proprietary mindset to a trusteeship mindset. That's very important. Sometimes it doesn't work that way. They still are going the old method of, you know, taking decisions like that they were the only owners. And the communication between them and the new investors is very poor sometimes. All these actually quickly lead to breakdown. And you have more hassles than actually benefits of taking on other investors. And this really is the fear. This losing control is not really the shareholding bit, but will there be a person looking over my shoulder? Today I am free, but tomorrow will I have this small harness around me? Or in terms of reporting, in terms of getting back, how many companies today here, even at a mid-level, actually have a board meeting? They may be private limited companies, but do they actually have a formal meeting with an agenda and notes to the agenda and so on and so forth? Now you will have to have, which actually strengthens you. If you take it in that perspective. So the fear really would be, will not really be of concern, provided your mindset is such that, yes, when I take on someone, I am actually going to be like a...